This is an example of comparing the growth of cells and bacteria in a system where we start out with mostly cells and just a few bacteria. And we're going to model these as autocatalytic reactions, since when we have one cell and because the nutrients present, we end up with two cells. Of course, two cells become four cells. So when we write the rate of reaction as a first order reaction, notice the thing that is different from in a typical non-biological type reaction is this is positive here. The rate that C forms, in other words, C is reactant, but C is a product, and the amount of C increases with time. So it's an autocatalytic reaction. The same for bacteria. And we're looking at the case where the rate of bacteria growth is higher than the rate of cell growth. Then the question is, if we run this in a batch reactor, we start with a large number of cells, a small number of bacteria, then how does this change as reaction proceeds? And so what we're going to do is write down mass balances. So it's a batch reactor. Change in concentration of cells with respect to time is the rate constant, concentration of cells. And the rate constant, 0.01. And the concentration of cells. For the bacteria, essentially the same type expression, except the rate constant is larger. So the way we've written these reactions, they're independent of each other. As long as there's enough nutrients present for the reaction to proceed, we can solve each of the equations the same way. I'll look at just the cell growth. That we can separate variables and integrate so that initial time to later time, initial concentration to the concentration at the later time. So the left side becomes the log of the concentration of cells and evaluated between the two limits. The right side evaluated between the two limits. So we end up with the log of the concentration of cells at any time over initial concentration equals 0.01 times time. Or the other way we can write this is the concentration of cells is equal to the initial concentration of cells exponential 0.01t. And you can see the same type calculation as the concentration of bacteria, exactly the same, but with a different rate constant. So what's going to happen is the cells are going to grow exponentially with time, but the bacteria are going to grow faster. So if we look at the ratio of concentration of bacteria to the concentration of cells, these are the initial values, and then we have an exponential 0.20t. Let's first write it this way, 0.01t. So this becomes 2 × 10⁶, their initial values, and the exponential 0.2 minus 0.01, so 0.19t. So what I did was just use a spreadsheet to calculate the concentration at various times to see how they change. So I've just listed values from the spreadsheet, and you can see initially, of course, the ratio is extremely small, stays small for quite a while, but between 20 and 50 hours, it actually increases more than two orders of magnitude, and time is in hours because the units of K appear hours to the minus one. At 75, now there's more bacteria than cells, and at 100, it's much larger, 120. So what started out as a very small fraction of bacteria now is the majority of species would be bacteria, and how long this reaction can go before it run out of nutrients is a function of what's in the system. But you can see the competition, if you like, the change in what's in the system between cells and bacteria depend very much on what these rate constants are.